Welcome back to Sports Locker Sunday. College basketball fans, March is just days away, and one of the teams hoping to have a memorable month is the University of Indianapolis men's basketball team. Head coach Paul Corsaro joins me now in studio. Paul, 25-3 this year. What has been working for your Greyhounds?
Really, it's just our student athletes. It's a really special group, and we're a really deep team. We're a really talented team, but the character of this team is really what makes us. They're a selfless group that doesn't care about anything but winning. They're great teammates, and they do everything the right way on and off the court.
You guys are just one win away from tying that program single-season win record. 26 wins way back in 1963-64. How much do you think of that?
It's special. I'm big on, you know, you always like to do firsts and, you know, making history. Who doesn't, right? And done some really cool things this year. You know, tied the program record for most consecutive wins in a season with 18. You know, last year we made the team's first ever GLVC championship game. So doing something else in terms of, you know, winning is the ultimate prize in sports. So if we can tie or break that 26 win mark, it would be really special.
Two of your big players, obviously, Jesse Bingham, Kendrick Choa, they're both averaging around 15 points per game. How vital have those guys been for the success with your team?
I mean, obviously very vital when you look at, you know, the point production, if you look at their field goal percentage, but, you know, they do more than just score. You know, Kendrick averages 8 rebounds a game. Jesse Bingham is, in my opinion, the best two-way player in the league. He had the primary responsibility of guarding one of the league's top scorers over the weekend and held him to 8 points. So they get it done in all facets.
It's something when you've seen this team grow, did you know that this could be a special group, knowing you guys made this conference tournament championship game last year?
Yeah, you know, when you make a game like that, you know you have something special. And we graduated two really good players, but we returned pretty much everybody else. So we felt pretty good, and we knew that if we went out and got the right pieces to add along with what we were returning, we'd have a shot. And credit to my staff, they did a really good job bringing in those pieces. And once we solidified that recruiting class, you know, we got pretty excited, and, you know, we thought we had a chance.
This tournament gets going this week out in St. Charles, Missouri. It's a familiar team that you guys are playing in the first round. Obviously, UIndy is the number one seed. Quincy is the 8th seed in this tournament. And Quincy is one of those teams, they handed you one of those 3 losses you all have had this year. Does that sort of give you that added, okay, we need to refocus and make sure we can't overlook this team?
Well, we really respect them. You know, I think their coach is a tremendous coach. You know, he was actually the head coach at Western Michigan in the MAC for 20 years, and, you know, he does a really good job. And, you know, they beat us fair and square at their place, and, you know, we were able to avenge that loss at our home court. But we know they're a very good ball club and that we're going to have to be at our very best to win that game.
The theme that you guys have had, and you've already been telling me, making it to the tournament championship last year. How much of a driving factor was it when you guys were watching that opponent cut down the nets and celebrate last year?
Well, we were up 18-0, and we didn't finish the game. And our whole offseason, our whole summer, our whole preseason, the word finish has been a key focal point. And that was kind of what happened this past week. You know, we were 24-2. We were on an 18-game win streak. We dropped one on Thursday, and we have one regular season game left. And, you know, we talked to our team about, hey, we're not going to talk about conference tournament. We're not going to talk about NCAA tournament. It's been a great regular season. We're going to finish the regular season the right way. And we did that Saturday. So hopefully we can move on to phase 2 of our season and finish there as well.
As an Indy guy, you're from Central Indiana. What has this experience just been like for you?
Well, it's awesome. I mean, went to Roncalli High School, went to University of Indianapolis. I take a lot of pride in being from Indianapolis. I love our city. Take a lot of pride in being from the South Side, you know, and it's awesome looking up in the stands and seeing family and friends at every game. Right when I go through the handshake line, the whole backdrop behind that basket seems to be full of my family members, and that's really special for me. But take a lot of pride in coaching at a place that I care about, like the University of Indianapolis.
You've been at U of Indy so long. I mean, the impact that you've had starting as an assistant there, now you're the head coach. Did you ever imagine that you would be having the success that you've been having?
You know, I always dreamed of, you know, being in the seat one day. You know, that was always the goal. I always thought that, you know, that'd be a dream for my first head coaching job, to be at the University of Indianapolis. And if I could be here for, you know, for a really long time, I love this place. And when you get that opportunity, you always want to leave a place better than you found it. And I knew that was going to be a tall challenge because there's been some great coaches who have done some great things there. So really it was all about getting the job and then just working hard and then do your best, put your best foot forward, surround yourself with good people, good student athletes, good staff, and make the most of it. And, you know, it's been a fun year so far.
No doubt. And that fun, hopefully, for UIndy continues this week at the GLVC tournament. Coach, best of luck out in St. Charles, Missouri, correct?
Yes, awesome. Correct.
Good stuff. Thank you so much.